everybody. It is day number 6. So here we are on the last day of our shapes. Tomorrow on day 7, we're going to put them all together into a design. So today we are going to work on a new shape. We have 5 shapes so far. You have the simple circle, the teardrop petal, the curved petal, the diamond leaf, the wavy leaf, and today we're going to do the heart. So the heart can be a little tricky because we see it as a very symmetrical shape. And on the worksheet, I do work with the symmetry of the shape. However, once you go to your sketchbook and start drawing them on your own, I'm going to encourage you to use your own style and make those hearts as imperfect as you want, because that is how they work in our designs. They look beautiful when they're our own style and they're drawn in our own way. So grab your pen and pencil, print out your worksheet, and let's get going on our 6th shape, the heart. So today is day 6, and it's the last shape before we put it all together. So the shape for today is the heart, and it can be used as either a petal or as a leaf. So let's get going on our heart shape. Now the tricky part about the heart is that it is a symmetrical shape, and it's very hard to get the two halves to look the same. But again, in your freeform drawing, that's the beauty of it. It's not going to be symmetrical. In fact, you'll probably develop your own style of how you want to draw this heart-shaped petal. In the end, it's not going to be this symmetrical. But for now, I'm giving you symmetry so that you can practice. So we're going to put it into a flower next. And this here, this could be like a 4-leaf clover as well as a flower. So you can trace these ones out and it'll give you a good idea of how these petal shapes work together. And again, you can print as many of these worksheets as you want so that you can practice the symmetrical version before you head off and do your freeform. Next, we're going to do hearts within hearts, just like we did petals within petals. So again, the heart can fit inside the second heart in any way that you want it to, whether it touches the edges or whether it doesn't. So you can try tracing each of these to give you an idea of how these petals will form with hearts inside of another heart. When you get into your own sketchbook and you're working on them freeform, experiment with putting them inside each other and see how it works for you. Our last row, we're going to combine our hearts and our circles. So here you see that I've put 2 hearts within each other and then placed a circle on top of it. If I was doing this in pencil, I could do each of the shapes and then erase. But because I'm doing it in pen, I will draw the circle first, and then I will add the petals in after. And as you get better with this shape from practicing it, you'll start to know where you want to place the petal and how much of it you want to show above the circle. The more you practice these shapes and the more you play around with them in your own sketchbook without judging what you're drawing, you'll start to come up with ideas and you'll start to understand how they fit together. That's where the designs will start to flow. You'll find it with lots of practice, your style is going to develop. As much as I show you different techniques and different ways of accomplishing things, your style comes from your own drawing and it comes over time. So grab that sketchbook and play around with this shape and see what you can do by adding it to the shapes that we've done so far. Tomorrow, we're going to put it all together and I'm going to show you how to draw a flower out of all 6 shapes.